Hey guys, Drew with GeoArm here again to talk to you about the M2M MNO2-LTE, whether it be the AT&T or Verizon version, and its connection for communications only in this video to Central Station. So if all you're worried about is just getting the signal sent over to Central Station, you're not worried about the interactive app, you don't care about app control, doesn't matter, just looking for signaling, this is your video. So what we're going to do here is we're going to go ahead and get this connected to the Honeywell Vista 20P. You want to make sure that your Vista 20P is powered down completely prior to working with this. So you want to unplug backup battery, unplug power supply, make sure that that's all handled. Now the first thing we want to do here is we want to go ahead and get the antenna connected. So you can see it's super easy to get that connected here. You just screw that on like so. Okay, now that's ready. And the antenna is also pretty neat. It's got a magnet, as you can hear there. So it'll stick to wherever you want to go. A lot of you will probably backfeed it out, which is what I would recommend, and then mounting this outside somewhere. The first connections we're going to make here are going to be for ground and for positive power. So the first wire we're going to take here is the black wire, and you're going to be wiring that into terminal number 4. So 4 is going to have a lot of other wires, more than likely, which are all ground, because this is the aux minus terminal. So keypads will be going there, expanders, other devices as well. So make sure you don't remove any wires from these two slots specifically. Now, the next wire we're going to wire in is the red wire, and that's going to be going to terminal 5. This is for positive power. Once again, there will be other wires in here. You don't want to remove them. Make sure you keep them in there and just wire these in there along with them. So now we have terminal 4, black, terminal 5, red. We're wired up for power. We're good to go on those two. So what we're going to do next is we're going to wire for communications. So you can go ahead and get the orange and white wire out of the way. You're not going to be using those. If you want to throw a piece of electrical tape over the end of them or just cut them back, it's completely up to you if you're not going to be using the app. The first connection we're going to make here is going to be yellow, and that is going to be going to terminal 23, which is tip. So you're going to take the yellow wire, screw it down into terminal 23, and get it screwed down and tightened up. Then you're going to take the green wire and you're going to be going to terminal 24, and you're going to go ahead and get that screwed down. Once that's in place, go ahead and lock it in. Also, if there's other wires in these in terminals 21, 22, 23, and 24, make sure that you remove them. Get them out of there, because this is the only thing that needs to be in those slots currently, because this is how it's going to communicate. So we now have it wired for power. We have it wired for communications. So we're ready to go here.
All you need to do now. Make sure to subscribe to our YouTube page and click the Show More tab underneath the video, where you can view valuable links pertaining to this product, similar how-to videos, and our low-cost, no-contract alarm monitoring services.